I'm Taisha.
And I'm Lindsay.
So, your students want to tackle NASA's Move It Challenge and build a rubber band powered crawler?
This is a tough one.
So we want to give you some tips to help you guide them if their crawlers don't work as expected.
Crawlers are big machines that carry tons of weight from one point to another. At NASA's Kennedy Space Center, a pair of colossal machines called crawler transporters have carried rockets and spacecraft to the launch pad for more than 50 years.
Did you know NASA's crawler transporter can pick up and carry 18 million pounds? That's the weight of more than 20 fully loaded commercial airplanes.
The crawler is very important to future launch operations at NASA, which is why it inspired this fun engineering design challenge for students called Move It.
In this challenge, students will work in teams to design and build a rubber band powered crawler transporter. Their challenge is to create a crawler that can carry a payload at least 1 meter.
To start, the crawler must be rubber band powered. It must also have at least 2 axles with at least 2 wheels per axle.
Your students can use any available materials to accomplish this challenge. Be creative. Here's what we use for our crawlers. Make sure the crawler is strong enough to handle a heavy payload. The sturdier the box, the better.
Make sure the holes are properly positioned so that the axles are even and the crawler is level.
Use something sturdy for the axles. We use pencils, dowel rods, or skewers. Note, skewers are flimsier. Keep them as short as possible. To reduce friction, consider running axles through a straw.
Experiment with different size wheels. Bigger wheels travel farther per rotation.
There are multiple ways to attach the rubber bands to the crawler. Feel free to do your own research. This is one way.
You can use any adhesive to attach the wheels. Different adhesive works better with different materials. We use a combination of tape and hot glue or super glue.
Now let's test the crawler with the payload.
Remember, when testing with a payload, you may want to start with a small payload, such as 50 grams, then repeat testing in standard increments up to 1 kilogram.
If your students encounter an issue during transportation, use the opportunity to ask them questions and improve their design.
It's all part of the engineering design process.